I have had the time of my life. Never felt that way before. Yes, I swear, it's the truth. And I owe it all to you. Hi guys, welcome to Scatlink here, and we're off for recap, hands-on impressions, basically, of my experiences on the Nintendo Switch. Yes, and this is not the thing, it's just a piece of paper. This was the scorecard that I showed you in the montage. Funnily enough, the montage should be going up on the 16th. It's actually just finishing rendering right now. I didn't have time to edit it this morning because I had work, which is annoying because I wanted to get it out as quickly as possible. And, yeah, that's a thing. If you were thinking, are we gonna have like all those bits of gameplay as separate videos for the full Monty of each game? That was the full Monty. I wasn't allowed to get like the whole bloody experience. So, but plus, I didn't have the battery power on my phone. Two, my power bank didn't want to work, so I had to work with what I had. Plus, they only recorded what they allowed me to record. It was the Nintendo staff doing it for me, of course, as they probably did with everybody, but they gave me a couple minutes on each one. I got the whole Splatoon battle in there, so that was pretty sweet. I think we missed the beginning bit, but he almost got that, so that was pretty sweet. And yeah, so I just want to. So first of all, I want to talk about the presentation. First of all, we'll talk about the end, because oh my god, Breath of the Wild, that new trailer was the absolute shit. That was unbelievably. Oh, I want it. It's like, it's blown Ocarina of Time out of the park. It's blown Twilight Princess out of the park. Every Zelda game probably doesn't compare at this point to the presentation that it's been given. Even though I will say for Breath of the Wild, when I was playing it, there was some frame rate drops, and I do, and I'm talking about the Switch version, by the way. I was playing it with the Joy-Con grip, and it was on the TV, and I pushed the first boulder down the hill on the way to the Temple of Time. And well, it was not going down smoothly. I think the reason being is because they just ported the Wii U version over to the Switch and then just changed the input so it registered from the Joy-Cons just for demo purposes, because they did say it was a beta build, so I'm guessing it was the same as the E3 demo when it was on the Wii U. But like I said, this was the Switch version. But I will say that the Switch controller feels amazing. I'll talk about that now and then get back to the presentation. I kind of segued and didn't realise. So, so you got these buttons here, and of course, like, it's not that thick at all. As you know, you have the two, you have L and R, and then behind them you have ZL, ZR, and it is roughly this size, like to scale, probably a little bit bigger. But yeah, even though it feels like the Joy-Cons are like tiny, like fit in your hand, as you saw when I was playing ARMS with my dad, the thing is that they literally fit in the palm of your hand. They're that small. But it's comfortable. It works. And when you slide them out, you have the two SL, SR, and maybe there's SL, SR on the other one as well. I'm not entirely too sure. I think I always had one side. I wasn't paying much attention to that because you don't use them when you're doing the boxing game. Because you use the top buttons, which in this case you're holding them like, well, like that. You'd be holding them like that in your hand or something. So, yeah. So I guess I talked about ARMS as well. But yeah, Breath of the Wild. I got up to the tower, but I couldn't actually get to that cutscene because I got ambushed by a bunch of bokoblins. They knocked me down the hill, but they pushed me down the hill more like. They tried to swing at me, but they kind of skidded and they pushed me off, so I didn't actually take any damage. I took zero damage in my run, but they pushed me down. I slipped. I tried to get back up there, punched them in the face with the axe, and then thanks for playing. So I guess if I got into the cutscene, I'll be able to at least watch that before getting kicked off. So I could have got back in line because there were like 25 systems dedicated to this and all in different formations. Joy-Con grip on TV, Joy-Con grip in tablet, portable mode, or whatever you want to call it. Freeview mode, I think it's called. I'm not too sure. Then you have, obviously, like the two Joy-Cons without the grip, or you have it on the pad itself, and they had all those versions. I played it in its standard form where you would get it out of the box. You would have the Joy-Cons in the grip, you would have the console tablet in the dock for the TV. And I've got some news about the quality, actually. I actually did ask some of the staff about the quality of the visuals, and I haven't heard it anywhere else up to this point. So that's a thing. So getting back to the presentation here. Getting back to the presentation that we saw on Friday, so many things going on in my head. This is completely unedited, by the way, other than that intro, because it was just so funny. But in my opinion, I had the thought early on. But anyway, I'm getting off track. The presentation. Super Mario Odyssey shocked me. I swear that everyone, including Miyamoto, said that we should have a Mario Galaxy 3. I'm guessing that evolved into Odyssey, and Odyssey looks absolutely amazing. You can see each individual Brussels of Mario's freaking stash. That is unbelievable. That is quality right there. You can see each individual like stitching of his denim overalls, like how they like put together and all that from the joints and all that. It's pretty sweet. I don't understand why the hat has eyes. Obviously, we'll know once it gets near Christmas time, 2017, and that's definitely on my list. Super Mario 3D World was like, I don't know, and it was multiplayer, so of course I just played it with my mates, and when he brought it over here, we just played it on my system, so that's a thing. What else was there? It's been a while since I've seen the presentation. Of course, so really anything about the presentation I pretty much played, but in terms of the presentation itself, in the montage that they showed before Breath of the Wild, they showed Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, not as its separate thing. It was also a glimpse of Sonic Mania, which was at the event, if you've seen the video once it goes up, because this video will not go up until that goes up without issue. Hopefully, like I said, it will come out on the 16th, because I'm recording this on the 16th, but obviously this will come out on the 17th, if we're lucky. So, you see what I mean here. One video a day, bleh, is what I'm still going to go with. But yeah, I'm just going through everything that's going on in my head right now. But yeah, we finally got there, and then obviously I started that little intro bit when we got in line. We were on the near the end of the back, but we weren't the last ones in there. There was still like at least I would say on average 30 people behind me still, so that was insane. That the people behind it, most of the line that I was in was obviously the winners line and their plus ones. There was a line on the opposite end, probably for VIPs, higher up YouTubers, stuff like that. Understandable, press and all that news. If Game Explain have someone from the UK, probably. And of course, they had a little booth in the place that I didn't actually show off in my video that had that kind of stuff. Problem is, you have to talk to Nintendo in order to actually get an interview, and if I knew that ahead of schedule, I would have, like, tried to actually do that during the Christmas period, try to, like, arrange to see if I could, like, instead of entering the competition hoping to win, secure my place like that, and actually be in that, having, like, a hands-on free impression, a professional, like, be one-on-one on a couch, unrestricted, non-in-the-box, or attached to wires, switch, and playing all the versions like on the couch, and that would have been amazing, but it is what it is. Not there yet. We'll be getting there. I have high hopes for the channel. But yeah, I'm fiddling around with my lanyard right now. So let's talk about more about the events that we went to. There was free food, free drinks, unlimited Pepsi or whatever you want, lemonade. You could have a Harry Ransom's mini fish and chip meal with mushy peas, or you could have like a nice meaty burger. I can't remember the brand. There wasn't really a brand that it said there, but that fish definitely tastes like Harry Ransom's. But yeah, so this is something that we got to take back, and even the buckle here is actually embroidered Nintendo, so that's pretty sweet. And they gave these to us in order to enter in the first place, so they know that we're already in there. So if we walk out for whatever reason to just check on something, we can come back in the venue without happening to show our ID again. That's how you get in. You didn't get tickets, you show your ID to get in. And then, so I'm going to talk about the video that we had that went up, that was the montage of the entire day, pretty much, of all the game footage and all that hands-on games. But this is like my first impressions of the console. Let's now start about it. I know this, I'm scatterbrained everywhere, because this weekend has just been absolutely insane, and it's probably one of the best weekends I've ever had. So I'm just so thankful that it's happened. It shows that my luck has turned, especially the fiasco of last year. But yeah, so when you walk in, you are given one of these, of course, as I've shown you, like the stamps and all that. Like, there's better quality here. I think I'm holding it upside down. Yes, I am. It's because the picture will be upside down here. There we go. So if I move my fingers out of the way here, you get a stamp for every game that you play, except for Super Mario Odyssey. That was just the trailer that they showed in the on the presentation. But once you watch it, you get a stamp for Super Mario Odyssey. And to be fair, my dad was impressed. To be fair, that's actually really awesome. Snipper clips. I don't know what that is. Maybe that was shown in the montage. That was actually the longest line to get into, and we were only like six people away, because everyone kept leaving the line and coming back in, because it was like so long. And that's only because that there were two Switch systems for that little teeny weeny booth, and I didn't show any footage of it because it wasn't really anything too dramatic. It was just like this 2D arts and crafts kind of baby looking, very simple puzzle game. But it was actually very intriguing and quite funny, really, because my dad kept chopping me into such teeny tiny pieces he actually killed me, and I had to respawn. But that doesn't penalize anything, about except for time. You just gotta cut yourself into certain shapes in order to solve puzzles. Like, you have to make a sharp thin point in order to pop a balloon, make it curved in order to hook stuff, make yourself a thin block, put maybe with a smooth end so you can like get into a small crevice and then push a button or something in order to activate it, use your flat end in order to move a pencil over into a pencil sharpener. It was actually very intriguing and good use of co-op, because it was a co-op only game as far as I'm aware, and you only get about 10 minutes play off of it. But the line did definitely feel like it took forever. Maybe it's because the tutorial itself doesn't take a long while, but there's no way to skip that. You have to beat those tutorial levels. So that might be why we waited so long, because it is quite chaotic. I think me and Dad actually blasted through it quicker than anyone else, even though he still kept killing me, which was kind of funny. But at the same time, I didn't get recording, because at that point I was low on battery. I wanted to get Sonic Mania, and yeah, we were waiting for ages, and I was just like, let's just do this and get the stamp so we can get a pin. Because it says here, play games, collect the stamps of a series special Nintendo Switch pin badge, ask a staff member for more details. So that's a thing. Splatoon 2, that was, I played the original Splatoon on my mate Connor Mez's Wii U, because he actually has the game. I tried a bit of the story mode in order to get a feel for the proper controls and all that, with the basic gun and all that. And to be fair, with a class controller, I couldn't do it. But because the pro controller of the Switch, or with the Joy-Cons, because they have motion built into them as well, gyro sensor, it's basically got that it's basically the pro controller or class controller of the Wii or Wii U, plus the Wii remote bundled into one. That the pro controller actually has motion built into it as well. So it's basically the Joy-Con grip, but it's unremovable. It's literally just a solid block for a solid controller for that specific use. I don't know if I'll get one, because, I mean, like I said, the Joy-Con grip, even though it looks a little awkward, it feels just so good to hold. I mean, everything's so close together. The analog sticks feel a little bit more like the PS Vita's. I don't have one, but I worked in CEX, so I have messed about with one of them before for testing purposes, trying to figure out how the console works. But yeah, the analog stick is obviously a little bit bigger than the PS Vita's, but it still feels clicky. But you can push it in for like an L3 kind of thing. What is this? Skyward Sword. But yeah, so that's something. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Mario Kart 8 for the Switch, basically. As far as I know, my montage is literally just finishing rendering. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. The only thing that I believe that were playable on that, I was playing the 8-player multiplayer table, so we all had the Switch in, basically this form. So portable form with the Joy-Cons on the side and whatnot. And I literally have tried every formation of the Switch. But for Mario Kart 8, I played as Link in the F-Zero car with the blue wheels, like basically my usual, and the parachute glider setup, which is my usual setup for the Formula Zero car. But I chose Link because you can't choose Miis, and Link's my favorite character, of course. Other than Waluigi and Luigi, but you know what I mean. Or DK for 200cc, but whatever, I'm going off topic. You can only choose from four stages, well, three stages and one random, of course, like usual, but the thing is, you only had Hyrule Circuit, the Animal Crossing Circuit in any season, and I think there was also Baby Park, that was it, because it was very simple for those who don't know what to do in the game. It's a nice, simple track, but also very carnage-heavy. I didn't experience any of the battle mode. I should have got back in line and went for a different machine, perhaps, because there were, like I said, three different setups. One for battle, one for two-player racing on one Switch, and then eight-player, linking all of them together, and that's what I was on. I came second in that race, so as soon as, because the dude like recorded like the first minute of gameplay for that race, and the only difference really compared to the Wii U version that you see in the video is the item and the Splatoon characters, and that's literally all it is other than the battle mode as well. Apparently, when I looked online when I got back home, before I went to bed because I had to get up early for work, Mario Kart 8 doesn't have... Mario Kart 8 Deluxe doesn't have any new stages, apparently. No actual, like, extra Grand Prix or race courses. It's just the battle mode, the Inkling male and Inkling female, probably as one character slot, maybe. I think they were two separate in the actual game, though. Maybe they have different stats, maybe that might be why. Other than the villager, because they... No, the villager did have two separate ones. I don't know, I'm going off topic again. But yeah, so yeah, you had that, and then, yes, that was really it, so, it still felt good. It was a little jarring because of the, like I said, the analog stick, but, because it was a fast-paced game compared to Zelda, and Zelda's control scheme is really different. It's like, X to jump, A to do action commands like usual, but then B is for run, Y is for your sword, or for your weapon, and I was like, I'm mashing B, why am I not swinging my sword? It's like, press Y to swing your stick, and I'm like, oh. High warriors then. But yeah, that's just a nitpick of mine. And of course, the control pad-ish buttons, is shortcuts and all that. So, that's something as well. I'm going back to that, so, yeah. What else was there? So yeah, Splatoon. I just talked about the controllers and whatnot. That I can't play Splatoon 1, but Splatoon 2, because it had the motion built into the controller, so it's like you're playing with the Wii U gamepad or with the Pro controller and the Wii remote strapped to it with two bloody rubber bands. Seriously, Nintendo, you should have just made like a add-on grip for it, really. Just like an actual peripheral plastic thing to hold it, like officially, instead of two rubber bands, and call that official. But yeah, I didn't do well, but I did okay. And the dude actually recorded the whole bloody splatfest, other than the first few seconds, because he pressed the wrong bloody button. But that's a thing. I thank everyone that recorded it for me, by the way. Every time I was on a console, a staff member was recording. So that's pretty sweet, because you have to be in the frame. You can't just have it, like, at the TV or whatnot, or just the TV. You have to be in the frame. Except for Sonic Mania, the dude was, like, doing all this and whatnot, keeping me in the frame, zooming into the camera. He was the most dynamic, and that was the final one. But yeah, he also recorded the whole of Green Hill Zone that I did on that, so yeah, so that's covered that. ARMS, it's basically like a Wii or Wii U game remote nunchuck, but it's obviously for the Switch, and it shows that the Joy-Cons are basically Wii Remote Pluses on steroids, because of the HD rumble and the extra gyro sensor and all that, and just the portability of it all and the extra buttons as well, was that you have an analog stick as well, so you've actually got more buttons on that than you do a normal Wii remote, and you have an analog stick that can click into a button as well, so that is really good. Plus two on the side, like I said, when you slide it out you have two extra buttons, so it actually makes the controller more usable as well. So they have this console is literally has everything you need. For most games, the one half of the Joy-Con set is really all you need for two player. You can play Mario Kart with both of them, or you can play Mario Kart with one of them. So, yeah, it's crazy, it's insane. The share button didn't work, of course. you couldn't press home. They were all demo machines that were preset to do what they needed to do. They weren't like actual like they weren't like Wii U's that you would get from the box. So yeah, arms, Dad was actually pretty good at that considering, but he was doing like drums. I was actually getting in there because it actually just felt more natural to me. But I really enjoyed that game actually. It's definitely better than Wii Boxing, which is what they're obviously trying to replace. Like, they're trying to say, hey, let's take this concept and then soup it up into its own IP. And obviously, arms is the new IP. First Splatoon, now it's arms. And I think we all know who's replacing Little Mac. Am I right? So, I mean, maybe people don't want to hear that, but it's obvious that this is obviously taking Punch Out and just souping it up so you do it across the stage and whatnot. Not the same gameplay, similar gameplay, but you know what I mean. Now, 1-2 Switch. Of course, that's the tech demo game of the Switch to obviously say, hey, you can take this on the go, put it over here, that's just your scoreboard, and now you have your little toys to play with, and this all comes prepackaged with it. Not something I would get. Mainly because of the milking minigame. If you didn't notice during the montage, that was actually clipped into three different areas, and all we were doing was this. You let your sick minds just picture that. That's what was going through our heads when we were just looking into each other's eyes. It was like very awkward. So obviously it's milking a cow. But not only do you have to do this, but you have to like press the button on like on the side and whatnot. In this bit when you take them out, yeah, you have to hold it like that, and then you have to like press that button and then move down like that. So not only are you doing this, you're also caressing it. Is this going to be marketed for free? Like free? Is this going to get like a free plus rating? If anyone at Peggy like have it or ESRB or whatever has any sense, that probably they probably would say you may want to rethink the design of that. Just saying, especially when you're only doing it with one hand, because when you're milking a cow, you always use two. But of course, one person has the other udder, so it's even more weird. I don't know how I feel about that. But yeah, so that weirds me out. Bull shows off the HD rumble. It actually does work. That just like the ice cube in the glass presentation that rattles you. You shake it, it rattles, you move it around, you can feel the balls moving around, you can hear them hitting the sides of the controller. I'm guessing like they have like a rumble pack, but they have like little sensors that move around to the gyro sensor as well, so it goes around. That's just how I picture it. It's like a block with like a line going around, and they just bounce around like that, and every time they like move around they cause a rumble, and when they hit the wall it kind of, I don't know. That's just what goes through my head. It's like rattling a box. Speaking of which, I think I've covered all the games that I played, actually. What else was there? The free Switch games that we played. Yes, done all those. Free publisher games. I tried Sonic Mania. I just did Street Fighter 2. It's just Street Fighter 2. It's basically the one I got on the Wii Virtual Console for Sega Mega Drive because it had the built-in Wi-Fi connection, which was the last episode of my final Wi-Fi matches. But instead of it called Super, it's Ultra, and the only difference really is that it's HD. That's as far as I could tell. I'm not a Street Fighter fan. I only played it just so to get a stamp, really, and just try it out. But I think in the full version you can switch to the original artwork, so it's all pixelated instead of having the HD redraw and stuff. So if that's how you want to go with, at least you've got like an up-to-date version that is up for grabs. So that's pretty sweet. And the last publisher game that I tried was Bomberman. Not really much to say. It was just Bomberman just souped up, really. I don't play much Bomberman games. Words. So I wouldn't really know how to compare it, to be fair. The only other one I've played is Super Bomberman 2, and I can't really compare that to a new game because that's like 20 years difference. So yeah. So semi-finally, like I said, I can't remember if I said it in the montage now actually, but there was another half to this because it opened like a booklet. If you put your name and email address on there and send it off, which today, by the way, is the 16th. I went on the 15th, which was yesterday for me. And that's when the montage was obviously recorded, of course. On the 16th, they were going to draw a winner from all those submissions for a free Switch. You could win a free Nintendo Switch at launch. I don't know how it'll be handled. Maybe they'll send it in post to your email address, perhaps, and track that to your home address, perhaps, or just send you a coupon so you go to your nearest game store or whatever and you just pick up a Switch free, perhaps, of your choice. I don't know. At least if you do that, you can actually pick up your game. Otherwise, you've got a Switch with nothing to play on it. So, I don't know. But yeah, the drawing takes place today, 16th of January, 2017. And then, within 5 working days, they will contact the winner via email. And then the winner has to, like, acknowledge or click receive on the email or something within 2 working, well, within 2 days of sent. If they don't respond to it, it becomes nullified, and then they pick another winner. And it keeps on happening until someone actually accepts the Switch, which I believe everyone's going to be watching their emails, like, with, like, hawk eyes. Sorry about that. Don't know what happened there. Lost my voice. But yeah, sorry for the sudden cut. I had to splice this in because I literally just finished recording, but I completely forgot that I actually mentioned this, but didn't actually follow up on it, which is kind of bad. Oh, I was talking about the output resolution of the Switch. Now, everyone was assuming that if it was in the dock, which goes to the TV, of course, it would be 1080p, but no one knew if it was going to be 60 or 30 frames per second. Probably 60, because the Wii U can do 60 with Smash Brothers 4. But if that's the case, then what would it be when you take it out of the dock, when you take it in a portable mode and take it with you? Take the tablet and the Joy-Cons and whatnot. Of course, depending on what game you play, the battery life can range from 2.5 hours to 6 hours. Breath of the Wild is probably going to be higher up on that, probably. But then again, maybe Nintendo would optimize it, and you could probably mess about with the settings, like adjust the brightness, adjust the maximum sound output, adjust the frame rate, perhaps. Like, have a limit, like 30 or 60 or 25, perhaps. You could probably set that stuff, or set it down to a lower resolution, like 480p, like the gamepad, perhaps, just to increase life expectancy, because as it's on a small screen, you don't need the best quality, but it's still nice to have. So, knowing all this, and not knowing how long it would last, like, just using Breath of the Wild as an example, here is the output quality of the Switch. When it's in the dock, it is 1080p, 60 frames. You would expect that to get completely halved in portable mode. No. When it's in portable mode, it's 720p at max, still 60 frames per second. Still 60 frames. So, even though you get, like, a quality downgrade from 1080p to 720p, that's understandable. It's on a smaller screen, you don't need that much quality, because it's getting scaled down in terms of physical screen anyway, so you don't need that much of a resolution. However, it still keeps the smooth gameplay of 60 frames per second. And I couldn't tell when I was playing Smash Mania, because I didn't have that in my mind at the time, because it's Sonic, it's going to be fast, you know for a fact it has to be smooth. But I thought, wait, is this 30 frames or 60 frames? I'm actually not, I don't have a clue. And when I was before we left the venue, I asked one of the staff members, and I got this information. I can't seem to find this information anywhere else, so this is kind of exclusive at this point. So, when docked, 1080p, 60 frames. Undocked, 720p, 60 frames. That's pretty awesome. Like I said, I'm super tired. everything's just going on at once. And I know this is a super long video, but you all need to really hear this. So, to be fair, just face it. If I win that video, if I win that Switch, I am making another video just pointing it out, because that would be insane. I'm not expecting it, really. I think I'm pushing my luck as it is just going to the event and winning that. But, you know, I wouldn't help, wouldn't hurt, would it? Saves me £280. Put that towards a special edition version of Breath of the Wild, perhaps. I was just planning on getting the game, really. But yeah. Me and my dad have both entered, so that's fair, because it's 2 separate emails, 2 separate people, so that's fair. So I'm very chuffed by that. So we have 2 chances, but then again, most people probably do. So, yeah, that's a thing. But yeah, that is my thoughts. But yeah, the final thing, as I've said, have a little bit of merchandise, the lanyard with the imprinted Nintendo on the logo. It's wrapped in sellotape so that the end piece here doesn't fall off. They kind of missed an opportunity of having, like, a hole cut out so you can keep it on there. You have to keep it in your pocket and fold it up, and it was annoying. But yes, getting all those 12 stamps nets you This box. Bloody glare. This box. Nintendo Switch. Fancy little thing. And I'm gonna open it up. I'm not proposing to you guys. It's not a ring. It's a pin. Can you even see that from the... Nope, the bloody glare. Ruin the reveal. Right, can I just... There we go. Nintendo Switch. Haha. That's awesome. Focus, please stop wobbling. But yeah, it's literally just a little pin. If I just pop that out here. Nice felt. Collector's edition. You can only get them at the event. Nice silver backing. So you just rotate this little locking mechanism thing by grabbing the thicker end and retain it all the way around so that all three holes are available. You push the needle downwards. Pop it wherever you want to put it without stabbing yourself, because the needle's actually kind of freeform, which, you know, for Nintendo, you wouldn't think that they'll be doing it that way. Oh, bloody hole moved. Push it back down and under, back into the hole, circle, move the lock around so it locks in, and there we go. I have a collector's pin. My dad's got one as well. He hasn't opened it. We're keeping it like that just so that we have some more worth to it. Because if it's unopened, it has more worth. This one does have worth. Like I said, they're collectible. They're probably worth... Well, they're probably... To be fair, they're probably not worth much. But considering that they're exclusive and they're legit, they're probably worth a lot. So that's kind of sweet. It's like, hey, I'll give you this for a Switch. I don't know. But yeah, I'm probably going to be wearing this quite a bit, to be fair. Just show it off. I mean, like I said, I have my Zelda hoodie, Zelda necklace, and then I have this awesome lanyard. It's a little itchy on the neck, but I'm not going to complain about that. And it's just, I'm just swagged out, man. Other than my glasses and my watch, it was just literally swagged out for the whole day. It was absolutely insane. It was probably one of the best days I've had in ages, to be fair. And it's funny as well, because my dad was actually quite funny, because like I said, he's not really a gamer. He's mostly on his mobile phone. He used to be, because he got me into gaming. I inherited the Super Nintendo from him, the original 64. I've got my own Pikachu one now. My brother's got that one. Yeah, it's Game Boy Color. He got me my Game Boy Advance. It's crazy. And he did go on the GameCube a few times, but I technically bought that one. But we kind of chipped in. He kind of chipped in a little because I was like £20 short, because it was one of the last ones in Toys R Us at the time. But yeah. So yeah, that's my hands-on impressions of the Nintendo Switch. Like I said, all the footage was in the previous video. I wanted to have that as like a montage kind of thing, and keep that separate. I don't know how long this video is, to be fair. If it's 40 minutes, it doesn't matter. It's freaking Switch related, so yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I don't think I'm gonna have any more Switch stuff coming out soon. I don't even know if I'm gonna stream or let's play Breath of the Wild. I probably just want to play it at my own time, to be fair. If I do win the Nintendo Switch, I will point that out, because that's just more news, and that just adds another console to the tally. And that also means that when I do get the Switch, and if I do win, I'll get the special edition of Breath of the Wild, or like Master Edition, whatever, and I'll do like unboxings of those as well, perhaps, maybe. But we've already got enough on the channel as it is still. I kind of keep making it worse for myself because I just moved Ico into the mix. But yes, other than these two videos, we're going to be back on track. We're going to be getting, we're going to be playing Earthbound, Ico. Whenever an Undertale video comes out, that'll be that, because everyone's doing essays at uni at the moment, and then people are stuck with work because it's the beginning of the year. Everything has to start up properly again. It's probably too busy. Stuff like that. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode, guys. Subscribe for more if you want. We're already at 800 subscribers. If we could just get to 1,000, we'll hit our next mark. I don't normally go for subscribers, but like I said, it's like, if I could do YouTube as my full-time job, I wouldn't mind, because that means more content for you, more fun for me, and it's just a good time all around. So I don't see the harm in it, really. More subscribers means more videos, in a way. I mean, I'm not gonna stop my videos. I just feel like I'm pushing now. I'm just going to shut up. And I'm going to say, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy what other stuff that's coming out on the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video or whatever I do next. Hope you're hyped for the release date of the 3rd of the 3rd, 2017. See you guys then.